Okay, so if you want to create a new Google slide, there's several different ways to do it, but the easiest way and what we'll be doing right now is just to go to drive.google.com and then left click on new, go down to Google Slides, and you can create a blank presentation or you can start from a template. We'll left click on from a template. This is going to do a lot of the work for us, and there are not going to be very many situations where starting from a template doesn't just really help you out. For this, we're going to use a template called Your Big Idea. And now we're going to go through the steps to kind of stylize and prepare this slide for your specific presentation and what the settings are that you need to change. We're going to look at these four options first. You could put an image in the background. And this dialog is just looking at the current slide, but if you wanted to add it to all of them, you would just left click Add to Theme. So we'll take a quick look at what that would do. If we changed it to red and added it to the theme, see all of the backgrounds just changed to red. But if I change it to light blue and I don't click Add to Theme, it just changes the current slide. So we'll click Done. We'll get rid of those two changes because they look hideous. And we're back to where we started. We're going to skip over to Theme. We'll come back to Layout in a minute. And if you left click on Theme, this is a collection of colors, fonts, backgrounds, and layouts that you apply to the slides. And then once you do that, they kind of look better together because they all have a similar theme. And they'll do smart things. Like for example, this background is kind of dark, so it makes the corresponding text light. And if it's a light background, like down here, it'll make the text dark. So since we started from a template, it already has a theme applied. But if I wanted to change it after I left clicked on theme, on the right hand side would be these different options. So we'll just click one to show you what happens. It will change all of the slides and they all kind of correspond to this new format. We'll do the undo button just to go back to where we were because we picked this because we liked the way it looked. And this is also where you could import a corporate theme if you had one. So if you go in the lower right hand corner and click on import theme, you could grab it here. Maybe it's in your Google Drive or you could upload it as well. Okay, we're going to go one back to the left, and the layout is a control for each specific slide. So if I left click this, these are designed for different types of content. So the one that you're looking at right now is a title slide. You can see that that's selected because it has a darker rectangle around the box. But after you choose a theme, then you can choose these different layouts for each particular slide. If you were building this from scratch and say you had a picture and you wanted a little caption, you might choose one column of text, right? So you put your text in this column, there's a little header box, and then you have plenty of room for an image off to the side. If I left click on the slide number 6 here, and I go up to layout, this one has something called section title and description, and it has a similar thing. Text to the left, and then a box to the right where you can put some content. And then once you have your theme chosen and your different layouts set, you can do transitions in between the slides. If you just left click on the slide that you want to transition, let's put it on number 2, and I've clicked on transition. Come over here and let's say we want it to be a fade. There's some controls that you can apply here, so we'll just make it medium. And you can see that it's added this icon on the second slide, and that's showing that there's a transition after this slide. So let's click present now, which we'll talk about more later, but we're just going to do it to see this transition. There's the fade. So this is the first slide. Go to the right and it fades out to the second one. But after that, there is no transition. So if I continue to move through the presentation, the slides just switch with no transition. We'll go back to the first one and there's the fade. We'll hit escape to get out of the presentation mode. And just look, these are the different types of transitions available. You can play around with them if you want, but you don't need them on there. So I'm going to take this one off just by left clicking undo. And now we're going to go over how to add some content to your slides. So in order to do that, let's just insert a blank slide. So we'll go to Insert, New Slide. The easiest way to do it is to first start with the layout. So let's do a title and two columns, just so we have a fair amount to play with here. And let's change this text. So this will be about, you need to speak clearly. And these controls that are up here are, you're going to be familiar with them because they're going to be similar to the word processor that you probably use or the spreadsheet. So if we select this font, it's already made it a font that kind of fits the theme, okay? And it also fits the text box that you have here. But if you wanted to style it, you could make it bigger. You could change the font family and all sorts of other different effects here that you probably know, so we're not going to go over too many of them. If you come down to add the text, if you add a couple of different lines, oftentimes you want to put bullet points in a presentation, and those are just put in by left-clicking the bulleted list option, and there you are. Let's say we want to add an image to the right. This says click to add text, so this is a text box. Let's just select the entire box by left-clicking on the blue rectangle around it and hit delete. And now we'll just go to the insert button, or you can use the menu options where you see the icon of an image. And there's different choices here for how to grab the image. You could upload it from a file that you have on your computer. You could search for it on the web. Or you may have it already in your Google Drive or your photos. And you could even just insert the web address for where the image is located and it will pull it in. And you can use your camera. So now we're just going to use Google Drive. And we'll just pick this image that I have that I know is mine so I can use it in a video. Put it on there, you know, because that has a lot to do with the presentation, right? We'll say you're presenting about a spreadsheet. How's that sound? And after you have this on here, then you can choose some different options. You may want to put a border around it. So when you still have it selected, which means there's still a blue rectangle around it, you could go up to the menu, left click on Format Options. And here you can control some things about the picture. So we wanted to do, let's say, a drop shadow. If you left click on the arrow, it'll drop down and show you more controls, but the box has been checked here. And let's just click out of it now and see what the drop shadow looks like. If you look closely, you can see a drop shadow. Let's go back and make it more intense. Let's just pull these to the right, see if it looks better. Left click off of it. Pull the transparency down. That's the problem. It was transparent, now it's not. And you can see the drop shadow. So that's just an example of one of these many things that you can do to customize your image. And we'll left click to come off of that now. You could add a video. So if you go to insert, there's a video option here. And if you left click on it, you could add it straight from YouTube if you just search for it here. Or if you have the URL for it, you could paste it in. Or if you have it saved, you could put it in Google Drive. It'll place the video in the slide, and then you can play it as if it's an embedded video on a website. And now you can also add an animation. So there's two different ways to think about what an animation means. You could just insert an animated GIF, so which is a picture file that just contains its own animation. Or you could take an existing picture. So we'll left click on this Sparklines example picture that we have. And you could left click on the insert menu and choose animation. And it will take this flat picture and you'll be able to apply a lot of pre-selected animation types to it. So if you click play now to see an example of this slide when it's live, it would have the picture fade in. Just like that. On the insert menu, there should also be insert audio. This is 2019, and there was a release saying that that capability was going to be added. Maybe by the time you see this video, that will be there. But right now, you have to use the workaround of inserting a video with the audio in it. But when the insert audio function is here, it should look at your Google Drive and you could input a music file or an audio file that way. So one of the big advantages of Google Docs, Slides, and Sheets is that you can collaborate really easily with other people that you're working with. So if you come up into the upper right-hand corner and you left-click on the Share button, this opens up a whole host of options for you to share this document with other people, let them view it and or let them edit it and comment with each other. So if I'm going to left click on advanced so you can see the different options. Right now I have it set to private and only I can access it. I'm going to change that and I can just make this public on the web so anyone can find it. I can just make the link viewable for anyone but not have it be searchable. And these options only exist because I'm using a G Suite account. So I can share it with someone else at my organization or anyone else at my organization. So if someone else is a user in my G Suite account, this can show up in their Google Drive as well if I click this option. That's available if you're using G Suite. If you're interested in G Suite, I have a link down below in the description and you can get a 20% discount if you contact me with the contact information down there. And that is an affiliate link. So if you use that link, you will help me to support my channel, which I would really appreciate. That'd be awesome. If you're not looking at G Suite, another way to share it, which is what I'm going to do right now, is say link sharing's off. Okay, I just want to share it with specific people. So if I click save, we'll get back to this screen that you were at before. So we don't need the advanced options to just share it with one person. So I'm going to share it with another Google account that I have. It says, are you sure this person's not in your organization? And I'll say yes. So I just received an email in my other account that says I've been invited to edit this Google slide. So I'm going to click on open in slides. And this on the left is a different Google account. So this person can be next door. They can be on the other side of the ocean, but they can make edits if you use that setting. So let's go back to the right and click share again, get this centered on the screen. It is shared with me. And if I drop this down, I set it so that I can edit it. You can also just share it with someone, but you don't want them to change it, but you do want them to be able to leave comments or just let them view. To give us the most flexibility to show this, we're going to leave it on Can Edit. If I come back over to the left, I could just start changing things, but I showed you how to change things before, so we won't get too into that. But another option that you have is you think that the guy with the account on the right should change this, so what you can do is you can insert a comment. I'm going to come down to insert comment. I'm going to say, please change this. I'm going to leave it as a comment. Then I come in to my original account. And you can already see this outline on the thumbnail showing that something's here. It shows you the icon of who did it. That good looking guy right there. Let's left click on this. It's going to bring up the commenting window. We could just have a back and forth chat here, but I want to see what the actual comment was. I'm going to make this window bigger again. Go up to the slide where the comment is, and this person said, please change this. So I'm going to come back and I just left clicked on it. I'll say, okay. And they want me to erase the G and hit enter because this is casual now. We're making presentations a stick. And I'll click reply so you can see the back and forth here. If I come back in as the original guy who asked them to change it, it's been resolved. So I'm going to left click on resolved and the comment goes away. So you could have a string of 20 comments and you could have the history on each of them and keep track of them as they get resolved. And when you're ready to distribute this slide, of course you can just left click on the present button. And if you have a projector, you can do the standard stand there and talk about it. Let me go back. When you have two different screens, you're going to see these controls that come up and you'll be able to go through the slides. You can set timing of the slides if you want and just click play. And you can also have some notes to yourself that you would see on one screen and not the other. Or you could use a super cool pointer up on the screen, kind of like a laser pointer. You could also publish this file to the web if you wanted to put it maybe on your WordPress site. And you can just have a link with the slides auto-timed. And if you click publish, that made this content visible to anyone by publishing it on the web. And here's your link to show someone the page. So if I click that link, and let's just bring up an incognito window. It's just a fresh browser window. If you shared that, people would see this full screen presentation. And you can click through it, or you can just press play like we talked about, and the slides will be timed, and it will go through on its own. Another option that you have is just embed, so you can control the size of it, but this will just put it inside a window in an existing website. So I click small, you grab this code and you paste it on the HTML and the back end of your website, and it will show on the page. If you're ready to do a few more advanced things like embedding a spreadsheet table into your presentation, check out this video in the upper right hand corner. And if you like this video, I have a bunch of others like it. You could subscribe to my channel and you'll see more of them. Thanks.